shuffling over there.
Oh.
I'm waiting for that sheep.
I got it. I got it.
Stretching your cervix because I got it there, but I couldn't get it past that.
Okay. So that cramps you up, right? I think I had this before, and I don't really talk about it, but I had an abortion one time. Is that what they gave me to open me up?
Yeah, they probably gave you misoprostol. Yeah. So Pitocin is going to take what occasional contraction you are having and gradually make it a little bit more uncomfortable and closer together. But we do low dose. So hopefully, you know, it's enough to get you a little bit more dilated so this goes in a lot easier. So we'll do it, and then I'll recheck in a couple of hours and see where we're at.
Okay.
All right. You will see blood on the tissue when you go to the bathroom. Okay. Very, very normal. It's just from the manipulation that I did.
Okay.
You did good.
These were 170 there.
Yep. 150 minus 2. Susie, did I tell you that already?
How many centimeters she got to be?
10.
Yeah, you were a tuber. You need to lay up to pee now?
Yeah.
All right, well, let me just review some of the paperwork with you.
This ain't in too deep, right? It's not.
Because what?
It's not in too deep, right?
No. I mean, I can adjust, I can pull this off and take it out a little bit.
No, I don't want to keep fucking with it.
I'll put it in one of those ways.
But if it's bothering you, I can take this out and just pull it out a little bit if it's bothering you.
It's just, I don't know if it's bothering me if I'm skeeving out.
Do you want to put something over it?
I feel like if I move, it's going to go in deeper. It's not, right?
No, but I can put, want me to put like a little...
Yeah, can you cover it so I don't see it?
Sure can. You can have all that clear liquid you want. As far as you
have. I just have a towel on there.
The refrigerator is there.
Or was she going to give me a take my
life? I didn't see a thing.
It's for me.
You took it after I left the room. Okay, so. So this is that. This is the birth certificate information.
Okay.
This is that in the smoking and drug thing. Mm-hmm. So just check anything off that pertains to you.
Okay.
Most of them will be NA.
Okay.
Baby's birth certificate information on here, his full name. This is the information that goes with the videos I'm going to show you.
Okay.
So if you know his name, you can put that down. You can put the date of birth after he's born. But this goes with the sudden infant death video that I'm going to show you.
Okay.
This one goes with the shaken baby.
Okay.
So anything you know, just do it ahead of time. It's easier. Here's a hepatitis back information. And if you think one of your nurses did a great job, you can fill that out.
Okay.
And after he's born, this is his pee and poop and heating log.
I log it every time he goes?
Yeah, when he pees and poops and eats.
Okay.
Just so we can, you know, keep track of it.
Make sure he's eating.
Consent for him for his vaccinations. Alright, so this allows us to take care of him after he's delivered. Just the normal oxygen, suctioning if needed,
right.
And the weights and all that kind of stuff. Nothing fancy. If you're definitely getting him circumcised, that'll be a concern.
They don't do it in here though, right?
No.
Okay. No, somebody told me at the hospital they did it in the room with the mother.
No.
Yeah.
Well, that's a consent that the pediatrician would get just before, okay?
Okay.
So you can sign there. Of course, you're right-handed, sorry.
Okay. I know I gotta sign all these papers with my crippled hand. My strong hand.
25.
Today is 3. I'm putting 92. Oh, good God. All right, and the time?
It's 21:45. And this is so that you can give the hepatitis vaccine. So if you just print your name there and sign there. Why she can't see the computer because her glasses are in here.
She's right looking for them now.
So those videos you have to watch. You definitely don't have enough going on, right?
Yeah.
So it's sleep safety, shaken baby, and crib safety.
Okay.
And just buzz me if you need to pee, and I'll show you the first time.
Where do you buzz at?
That would help. Sorry about that. Susie, and the TV controls on here as well.
Okay, thank you very much.
You're welcome. And I'll get you something. Oh, is that okay? Do you need ice or anything?
No.
You good? Okay.
There's water, please. Can I get some water?
All right, so yes.
Susie, can I get some water?
No COVID test for you.
Susie, can we get some water?
Yeah. I want me to show you where to get it, and then you can.
Yeah.
Oh, hold on. Blankets,
quilts, toys. She'll
go after. Okay. Yeah, because then I'll show you where the kitchen area is, and then she can get anything for you that you need.
Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And
the Consumer Product Safety Commission caution against the use of crib buffer pads. Just like a pillow or thick blanket, I'll try to lay down a little bit. Pads
can restrict a baby's breathing if the bumper is next to the baby's nose or mouth. Remove crib buffer pads from your crib.
Only make sure your baby sleeps on a firm mattress, made especially for a crib or bassinet. Never use a pillow, water bed, adult bed, couch, sheepskin, comforter, or other soft surfaces.
So she fucked it up.
Yeah,
she got it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I think.
She
got oh, a good vein, and you can't even
get it. She
got
it. She jammed in there. And then he was doing it right in where I got it from. I can't even use paperwork. They just don't have to do it.
Just put CH. Initiated. It's initials.
I think it's like air for the baby. It's here by the air thing. So.
Yeah, she got this shit jammed in her. But I don't want to keep fucking with it. You know?
Well, you better tell her now, get that shit over here. So she can fix it.
That's gonna be a big ass thing.
That's why you want her to fix it now.
Huh?
That's why you want her to fix it now.
Is it there?
Mm-hmm.
Secondhand smoke increases SIDS.
Studies show that using a low-speed ceiling fan in addition to placing your baby on their back can further help reduce the risk of SIDS. Tell everyone who cares for your baby, including grandparents, friends, and babysitters, to place baby on his or her back every time they go to sleep. The recommendation that babies sleep on their backs may not apply to babies who have certain medical conditions. Your baby's doctor can advise you on which position is best for your baby. Remember, late preterm infants require feeding every 2 to 4 hours and should not be allowed to sleep through feedings unless instructed by your healthcare provider.
Now I know what his nervousness is. He's quiet in a bit. I figured you out. And you record.
What?
camera, you could have brought that and set it in the corner and had to look into the Wi-Fi and record it. They would have never knew. Yeah? The whole